It's time for you to make a move and you need to sell your house. And you may be wondering, what does it cost for me to sell my house? We're going to talk about that in just a moment. Hi, I'm Amy Clarkson with the Clarkson Premier Team. We're a real estate team that services West Fort Worth and the surrounding areas to include Granbury. Thanks so much for watching today's video. We publish a video every Wednesday and I want to make sure you don't miss out. So make sure you hit the subscribe button and the bell so you'll be notified of every new video each week. Today's topic is going to be about what does it cost for you to sell your home? The first cost you might have when you're getting your house ready to sell is prepping it to put it on the market. That might include some cost for painting or repairs. It may also include some yard work or some power washing cost, things like that. You want to get your house ready to go, and you might even have to pay for some storage to declutter your home because you want to make sure it's in the best possible condition when you actually list it. But once you list your home, your costs are over until it comes to the closing table. And we're going to talk about what that might look like for you in the way of cost so you can understand what your bottom line is. So once you get that contract on your home, there are a couple of expenses that can definitely be negotiated between a buyer and a seller, but there are some things that typically sellers are asked to pay in a closing. So we're going to walk through each of those costs. The first cost to be negotiated is the title policy. The title policy can be paid by either the seller or the buyer of a transaction. Typically, the buyer is going to ask the seller to pay for that, but it could be a buyer's expense. To find the cost of a title policy, it is based on sales price and a mathematical formula. And once you have that sales price, then you can find out what a title policy cost would be. The second cost would be what's called the home warranty. A home warranty is something that a buyer asks a seller to pay for. It's a one-year home warranty to cover the major appliances of the home, to also include some electric and plumbing issues and the HVAC and water heater as well. That is definitely something that can also be negotiated, but can range anywhere between $500 on up to $800, depending on if you have maybe a spa or a pool or things like that as well. Another cost that is involved for a seller is you're going to pay your prorated taxes from the January 1 to the day you sell it. Now, if you are someone who escrows those taxes, you will get a refund from your mortgage company when your mortgage is paid off, but that will come out of your closing cost for the prorated taxes. Another potential cost for you could be the survey. When you purchased your home, you might have received a survey at that purchase, and if you have not made any changes to the property of your home, you could potentially use that existing survey. You would do what's called a T47 and let the buyer know that you haven't made any major changes to the property, and it could work for this transaction. Reasons why it might not work would be if there was something, an issue with the survey, the title company may not insure it, or the lender may have some issues with the survey. So that could be a potential cost for you. And depending on the size of your property, it can range anywhere between about $450 on up to $1,000, usually for larger acreage of homes. But you're thinking on average, it's about $500 for a survey. Another cost involved when selling your home are what we call title fees. Both a buyer and seller will have a fee to pay to the title company to close this transaction, and they will also have some recording fees that are involved there. I usually lump those together when I talk with my seller about that, and I say that all those fees, the title fees, the recording fees, and things like that, average about $500 for you in the way of a cost to sell your home. And then, of course, you may have some HOA fees. If you live in a homeowners association, there may be fees involved for you to sell that home. And that is something that can be negotiated between you and the buyer, but that could be a potential cost for you when selling your home. One of the very largest expenses for you as a seller when selling your home are the commissions. That is something that you and the listing agent negotiate at the very beginning of your listing. And so you know what that cost is going to be at the very beginning. And so when you get an offer, you've already decided what that percentage might look like. Once you receive the offer and you know all the terms, and your real estate agent should prepare for you what's called a net sheet so you can understand, based on the offer that was given to you, what you, the seller, will net from that transaction, and then you can negotiate accordingly. Now, typically, depending on how you negotiate those items, your cost as a seller are going to range between 7% and 8% of the sales price. I hope we've answered all of your questions you might have about what are the costs for selling your home in today's video. But if we haven't and you have more questions, feel free to leave a comment or contact us with our contact information below. We would love to answer any further questions you might have, and we are always looking forward to helping you make a move, no matter what that looks like for you. We hope you have a great day and you tune in to next week. Stop! Why are you videoing me? I'm already being videoed here!
This live video has more viewers than your YouTube.
Oh my goodness, are you doing this live? Do it live!